everyone. I'm Dr. Aparna, Chief Neonatologist, KIMS Cuddles, Hyderabad. It may often be intimidating to be surrounded by the armamentarium of different medical equipment that we see in an NICU. Let's try and see what are the common equipment we have and what we use it for. This is a baby who is being nursed in a radiant warmer. Basically, there are two types of devices we use to keep our babies warm. One of them is a warmer and the other is an incubator. The warmer basically has a heating element which is surrounded by reflecting mirrors to give the baby radiant heat, and this helps to keep the baby warm. This baby is currently connected to a ventilator, which is a device for giving respiratory support to the baby. This is a high frequency oscillator, and this is one of the highest modes of ventilation, and we are supporting this baby for a condition called meconium aspiration syndrome. Sick newborns also have multiple tubes placed on their body. So they have ECG leads which are used for checking their heart rhythm, and we may be using a few lines such as a peripheral intravenous line for giving infusions and a central venous catheter for giving blood pressure medications and medications to increase the baby's cardiac function. We also have a peripheral arterial line in this baby for continuous monitoring of the baby's blood pressure. Let me show you the syringe pumps, which are the devices used for giving the baby closely calculated, titrated volumes of fluids, parenteral nutrition, intravenous drugs and other medications for keeping the baby sedated and for keeping the baby free of pain. All the babies are also connected to a multi-para monitor, which is a device which helps us to monitor various parameters such as the heart rate, the ECG pattern, the oxygen saturation levels, the arterial blood pressure, the respiratory rate, amongst few other additional parameters which we can add on to these monitors. The baby also has a feeding tube, and this is a pipe that is used to feed the baby with calculated volumes of milk, and this tube may be used for preterm babies who are too small to feed orally, or for sick term babies who cannot be fed orally because of the underlying disease conditions. This feeding tube can be either inserted into the baby's mouth or into the baby's nostril, and the end of the feeding tube is placed in the baby's stomach, and this helps us to continue feeding for the baby even while the baby is receiving intensive care. It is always a good practice to encourage early feeding whenever the baby is stable. The baby also has a urinary catheter for measuring the urine output continuously, and this is a temperature probe which helps us to measure the baby's skin temperature continuously, and this is displayed on the radiant warmer. This is another type of NICU bed, and this is called as an incubator. This is a specialized box which is made up of two layers of plastic, and this device provides a continuous warm circulating air current which helps to keep the baby warm. So we have covered this baby with this cloth in order to give the baby a nighttime environment and to encourage the baby to have the normal circadian rhythm, that is the cycling of day and night, so that the baby can have normal sleep. Whenever we want to access the baby, the doctors and nurses use these portholes or the access openings in order to touch the baby, examine the baby and to provide any kind of care like giving feeding with this tube or adjusting the endotracheal tube for ventilation or for placing intravenous lines. This preterm unit is being nursed in the incubator and is provided respiratory support with this ventilator, is being continuously monitored on the multi-para monitor, and is also receiving intravenous fluids, parenteral nutrition and enteral feeding by a OG tube. So this is required for the care of preterm babies, particularly those babies below 1000 grams and less than 30 weeks of gestational age. This is another form of respiratory support called as nasal CPAP. This is found to be a gentle form of respiratory support and avoids the need for a breathing tube placed in the baby's mouth. Preterm babies such as this baby may be requiring this form of respiratory support, nasal CPAP or high flow nasal cannula, for days or sometimes even weeks. CPAP has revolutionized the respiratory support of preterm babies because it helps the baby's lungs to grow and to mature, and it also helps us to avoid some complications such as ventilator associated infections and pneumonia. Babies with milder respiratory issues would generally be manageable with lesser forms of breathing support such as nasal cannula oxygen, like in this baby. Usually oxygen support is provided in the form of a box called as hood box and a nasal cannula. Babies with more severe respiratory distress require nasal CPAP or high flow nasal cannula, and the babies with even more severe forms of breathing difficulty may require assisted ventilation device called as a mechanical ventilator. All these babies require appropriate evaluation for the possible reasons. So whether this is because of more fluid in the lungs, which is called as wet lung syndrome, which is very common after the baby is born and settles on its own in few hours, or whether it is because of prematurity and immature lungs, or sometimes because of aspiration of amniotic fluid containing meconium. This may be done with the help of appropriate blood tests, X-ray, and sometimes an ultrasound. Thank you.